Hello everyone. Today my presentation topic is test item analysis. Even after an exam, how do we know whether the exam using testing tool was good one? Is it obvious that any exam can only be as good as item is comprises? But then what constitutes a good exam item? Our student seems to know, or at least they believe they know. But they are correct when they claim that an item was too difficult, too tricky, or too unfair. So today I want to tell you about test item analysis. It is basically a statistical technique which we use to selecting or rejecting item during test construction on the basis of their difficulty level, discrimination power, or on the basis of the errors. Next, we have purpose of test item analysis. So the purpose of an item analysis is to improve the quality of an exam or test by identifying items that are candidate for retention, revision, or removal. Specifically, not only can the item analysis identify both good and deficient item, it can also clarify what concept the examinee have and have not mastered. So what procedure are involved in test item analysis? The specific procedure involve worry, but generally they fall into one of two categories. Let's see the types of or the categories of test item analysis. The first category is qualitative item analysis. Qualitative item analysis is all about the quality of test items. So in this process, teacher or expert or a person who construct a test does proofreading before administrating the test, check the structure of the text and its grammatical error. Second, we have quantitative item analysis. From word quantitative, we have an idea. Quantitative means in quantity. It contains the numeric value for test item analysis. We often found three numerical indicators during the qualitative item analysis. But here we talk about only two, which are very important. So we do quantitative item analysis for obtaining the difficulty level index, how much item is difficult to attempt, or the item discrimination means to differentiate among the weak and intelligent student. Next, we have item difficulty level index. So difficulty is simply the percentage of a student who answer correctly in the exam, or who know the correct answer of the test item. So item difficulty ranges from 0.25 to 0.27. if the test item difficulty level below than 25, so item is very difficult, we cannot include it into the test. While the range is above 0.75, so the test is so easy and every student can attempt it, so we also cannot include in our test. Difficulty level index also denoted by, or we represented by P, or we can set that P value. So now next is how we can find difficulty index. So here we have a formula. We take number of students who answer correctly divided by total number of students. So next we have an example of a difficulty index in which we have 6 students and 5 test items. So first we total the correct responses of the students. Then you can see this. Here we find the difficulty level of first test item is 0.8, so it is very easy, and most of the student, even I think all the student can attempt it correctly. Now next we have 0.6. It can be included in the text. It is a good test item. Again we have 0.6. It is also included in the test. Now next we have 0.5. It is, you know, average difficulty level, not so easy, not so difficult. So next we have 0.3, can be included in the test. Test must be have some difficult questions. So in the last we have 0.1. It was really very difficult. So we have to discard it. We cannot include it in the text. Next we have item discrimination. Discrimination is basically the differentiation, or we can differentiate from one thing to another. So it is the ability of an item to differentiate among the students on the basis of their intelligent and, you know, weak student. As much as discrimination is high, means test item differentiate properly, means discrimination should be high if the test item is correct. You know, if it doesn't properly differentiate between the intelligent weak student, the item was not good. So next, let's see item discrimination index calculation, how we can calculate the discrimination. So first step is to divide the group of test taker into two groups, means high level and low level, or you can say that high scorer or low scorer. Ordinally means you have to sequence it by their scores and divided into scoring above and those scoring below, means you can say you must be take median. Now next we have compute item difficulty level separately for our upper and lower limit. You have to calculate individually difficulty level of upper level, means high scorer group and low scorer group, then subtract two difficulty levels such that, means now you have to subtract upper level difficulty level from lower. So we also denoted discrimination by D. So here is a formula: D is equal to difficulty level of upper level and difficulty lower level. If the value of discrimination is negative, it means the test item is not properly discriminate the intelligent and weak student. So if we get value in minus, so it is not properly discriminate or differentiate between the weak and intelligent student. Next we have an example of discrimination level. Here again we have a table, same table, in which 6 student, 5 item, total difficulty level. So discrimination level, test item 1. By calculating individually difficult level, here yellow color shows the high scorer while light blue color shows the low scorer student. So I calculated individually both difficulty levels and then calculate the discrimination level. You can see here test item 1 0.6 minus 0.6 equal to 0, no discrimination. Intelligent student also attempted very well while weak student also attempted very well. So the item is not properly differentiate between intelligent and weak students. So we need to discard this item. Next we have same case in test item number 2, but in test item number 3 we have different result. 1 minus 0 equal to 1. So it is a value, it is a value that discriminate between intelligent and weak student. So again we have same case, 0.6, no discrimination. Next we have a example in which we have discrimination. So Now let's look relationship between difficulty value and discrimination power. Both are complementary, not contradictory to each other. Both should consider is selecting good item. When we want to select a good item for our test, we should consider both of them. You know, if an item has negatively discriminate or zero discrimination, so it's to be rejected. If as I'm telling you before, if the item negatively discriminate, so we have to reject it, or whether it showed zero value, we have to reject it, whatever the difficulty level is. So this is all about the test item analysis, and